Hello, this is New Vision TV. I am Lynn Komjisha. Today we have a special report. The wave of reviving cultural institutions based on tribe has thrown Uganda and Kenya in a giant basket of confusion. The giant Kalenjin community that occupies the eastern side of the Great Rift Valley in Kenya and around Mount Elgon is in the process of establishing a cross-border kingdom in Kenya and Uganda. This comes amid reports that the Rwenzururu Kingdom has intentions of forming the coined Yira Republic across the Uganda DRC border on the western part of the Great Rift Valley in the Rwenzururu Mountain region.
On a bright Sunday morning, this group of Kalenjin elders, comprising mostly those from the Sabin community, entertained locals on the Kapukwai Hill, Chema sub-county in Kapchorwa district. This is the venue where the Sabin community has set up a cultural center to recollect on their rich heritage dating back to centuries of migration from Turkey, where local scholars and elders claim is the origin of the Kalenjin community.
It's about celebrating our identity because a long time ago we had cultural elders who used to mentor young people, used to do good things for the community. And with time, we got a king who was actually elected by the elders council. Until 1966, when the king died, and shortly kingdoms were abolished in Uganda, and when they were reinstated, Sabin was left out.
The official opening of the cultural center was supposed to be a historic day, during which other initiatives, including the launching of the Moi International Marathon, named after the former Kenyan president, was to be witnessed by Kalenjin elders, some of whom traveled from Kenya to represent their small tribes and clans. According to the organizers, owing to bad weather, President Moi's son, Senator Gideon Moi of Baringo County in Kenya, was not able to fly from Eldoret town on the advice of his chopper pilots. President Moi is arguably the most prominent Kalenjin politician and statesman.
The grandparent of all the nine Kalenjin subgroups that are scattered all over the globe due to previous calamities or just moving for greener pastures. And we have this initiative was started to identify with them and celebrate our culture and promote tourism.
Meanwhile, as the elders waited in hope that the weather in Eldoret would change to allow the chief guest to fly to Kapukwai, they addressed and lectured on their cultural heritage. It is at this point that some revealed that the establishment of the Kalenjin kingdom is in the pipeline.
Advisors to the king. Those are technical advisors to the king.
We are going to see how we can promote art and literature, music, dance and drama, and in tangible heritage we need to identify our artifacts.
But a recent remark by police spokesperson Andrew Felix Kawesi during the display of weapons and items alleged to have been recovered after the Rwenzururu Palace attack explains government's position on traditional institutions.
Kingdoms possess political authority. So we don't have kingdom. We have cultural institution. But we interchangeably use the word kingdom in a simple way. But that is a mistake. The cultural institutions can exist with a particular head who is elected to be there, who is hereditary put to be there. So when that person gets charged and he has committed crimes, the institution decides as per the demands of the day.
On his part, Bushendich points out that the process of forming the Kalenjin kingdom is in high gear and the potential king has been identified. The Kalenjin community comprises the Sabin in Uganda, the Marakwet, Keyo, Elgeyo, Pokot, Sabaot, Terik, Nandi, Ndorobo, Kipsigis, Tugen and the Elgon Maasai in Kenya, together with other tribes in Ethiopia and southern Sudan. Their population is estimated at over 7 million. This community boasts of world record-setting athletes. The arrival of one of the famous Sabine foretellers at the Kapkwai function showed how the community has high regard for its cultural leadership. He is from the Kapkwai clan that is expected to provide the king. During his address, the gathering remained attentive, probably to listen to what he would foretell. Thereafter, he led in a dance that almost led to the closing of the ceremony before government officials and political leaders would address the gathering. Other leaders were more committed to speak about the establishment of the cultural center than the Kalenjin kingdom.
We are trying to reform those in Ethiopia and also in South Sudan. They are all going now, like now, the Murle, the Dinga, the Mbuya, the Maram in Ethiopia, the Sirma, and then the Marile in also in Ethiopia. We shall all inform them about the new kingdomship of Kalenjin's group.
The RDC capturer, Jane Francis Kuka, was concerned that the central government should step in to support the establishment of the cultural center, given the fact that it would boost tourism in the Sebei region, which comprises three districts of Kwen, Bukwa, and Kapchorwa.
Here, there is about 11 billion which comes for tourism, even the culture. But we requested through the executive of this place to get something for this day, but it has not arrived.
The Kalenjin are mainly a pastoralist community. But in recent years, they have aggressively embraced agriculture. The Rift Valley is Kenya's food basket, and the Sebei region may soon become a key banana and coffee producing region in Uganda. This is evidenced by the beautiful plantations that have made the Sebei landscape even more beautiful, not just for tourism. This as the community commits itself to stop female genital mutilation, for which it has been castigated for many years.
And that's all we had for you. Thank you for watching. Be sure to catch more of your updates on your mobile, anywhere on the go. I'm Lynn Komjisha.